Hi, I'm Brett Williams, director of the Sanford Performing Arts Center and a wicked proud Mainer. And during the season of social distancing, our theater is closed. And I'm home in Sanford with my wife, who is a superhero nurse, and our sons, who are 9 and 6 years old. And with school closed, we're suddenly homeschool teachers, and that is not always easy. The kids are just as thrown off by all this as we are. And sometimes it's hard to get them to focus on schoolwork, but I asked my six-year-old what he thought of the whole situation, and he told me he's loving how much time he's getting to spend with our family. How can you argue with that? So it's just a good reminder that even though we're missing our jobs and our routines and gathering to enjoy live performances together, for example, we have this great opportunity to make lifetime memories with our little ones. And I often wonder how their young minds are gonna package this whole season and remember this chapter in Maine history. And if you don't have kids at home with you, reach out to check in and encourage other families who do, because it's hard work and there is no break. Also, every teacher should get a raise. All right, today we're looking back at a chapter in Maine history. It happened just a couple of miles from here. And on this day in Maine, in 1905, flames sweep through the business district of Springvale, consuming 2 shoe factories, 20 commercial buildings, and 15 residences. Everything made of wood was lost. The fire began in the boiler room at the W.R. Usher & Son Boot and Shoe Factory. And local firefighting equipment was inadequate, and the flames were not contained until a Portland brigade arrived on a special train. And amazingly, no one is seriously injured in the fire. But it was devastating. The total value of the property lost is estimated at $300,000, which would be more than $8.6 million in 2020. And it led to hundreds of people relocating. And I'll just put in a plug for the Sanford Springvale Historical Society, where you can see amazing photos of the fire and its aftermath, of course, when it's safe for them to reopen. Hang in there, Mainers, we've got this. Stay strong, stay healthy.